Afternoon, everyone. During the last lecture, we have seen the gyroscopic couple or the gyroscopic effect and how this effect is experienced in the spinning objects like disc, flywheel, or the wheel. Okay. So today we will discuss about the gyroscopic effect or the gyroscopic couple on the naval ship. So when the ship is sailing in the sea water, it experiences the gyroscopic couple during the steering motion, pitching motion, and the rolling motion. Okay. So first I will show what are the different types of motion a naval ship will experience when it is sailing in the sea water. So you can see in this video various types of motion for the naval ship. So the first motion, it is the pitch motion, or we say this as a pitching of the naval ship. So pitching means what? The naval ship will move up and down. So this is the pitching motion, and this motion, it takes place around the horizontal axis. The second motion, it is the rolling motion. So rolling motion, it is basically the tilting of the ship about the horizontal axis. So this is called as a roll. So this is the tilting about the horizontal axis. And this sideway movement of the ship, this is called as a yaw movement. Okay. And also the gyroscopic couple, it is produced when the ship is steering to the left side or to the right side. Okay. So we will discuss this in detail. So for your syllabus or for this module, we will only deal with the steering and the pitching motion. Okay, and how the gyroscopic couple is produced in the steering motion and in the pitching motion. Now you have got the idea what is meaning of pitching and what is the rolling. Okay, so this is the schematic or the symbolic diagram for the naval ship. Okay, so this is the front view. So the propeller side, so this is called as a bow or the fore end. Okay, so basically this is a front end and this is the rear end, that is called as a stern. Then the side ends, one is a starboard and second is the port end. Okay, so this is a starboard end and this is a port end. And this is the right hand side view. So this direction for the angular velocity, so it is the angular velocity of this propeller. So this propeller blade, it is rotating in this direction. So if you observe from the right hand side, then it is rotating in the clockwise direction. Okay. Now we will discuss this gyroscopic effect or the gyroscopic couple when the naval ship is taking the left turn or the right turn, that is called as a steering motion. Okay, so observe in the top view. So this is the top view. So in the top view, if you want to take the left turn or right turn, okay, so basically we are changing the direction of the axis of spin of the propeller And when any axis of spin is rotated about the perpendicular axis, then the gyroscopic effect is developed. Okay, so we have to discuss this with the help of the angular momentum. So in the last lecture, I have already explained what is the angular momentum and how we represent the angular momentum for the spinning objects. Okay. So first we will discuss a case where the propeller of the ship is rotating in the clockwise direction. So this is observed from the bow end, that is the front end, and if the ship is taking the left turn, okay, so if this is the condition or this is the case, then what is the direction of gyroscopic couple or the gyroscopic effect? Okay, and how that gyroscopic couple going to affect the motion of that ship? So here I have drawn the realistic view. Okay, so this is the bow end, that is a front end, and this is the rear end, that is called as a stern. So this is just a terminology used in the naval ship. Now to visualize the gyroscopic couple, we have to assume the reference axis. So I have drawn here the horizontal axis. Okay, so this axis, which is passing through the center of this propeller, so this is the spinning axis. So we can take this as a x axis. So both this axis, so assume this as a y axis. So x and y, they are lying in the horizontal plane. Okay, so we can assume this plane as a plane of the seawater. Okay, and this propeller, it is spinning about this axis. So what is given condition? The propeller of the ship is rotating in the clockwise direction observed from the bow end, that is the front end. So assume the observer. So this is the observer. Okay, so the propeller is being viewed from this direction. So this is the observer direction. Okay, so from this direction the propeller of the ship is rotating in the clockwise direction. So this is the direction of the rotation or the direction of the spin of this object, which is a propeller. So why this direction is important? So this direction is important to decide the direction of angular momentum vector. Okay, because the complete gyroscopic couple is dependent on the angular momentum vector. Okay, so these are two axes, x and y, they are lying in the plane of the seawater, and we have to assume one perpendicular axis to x and y. So this is the perpendicular axis. Okay, So this axis, it is the z axis. So it is exactly perpendicular to x and y axis. Now when the ship is taking the left turn, we will discuss both the cases, that is the left steering and the right steering. So for the left steering, that means to turn the ship on the left side. So left side means, so now we have to observe in the frame of reference of this ship, okay? So if you observe from the top direction, this will be your left and this is the right direction, okay? So assume you are sitting in the ship, okay? And this is your front end. So this is the ship sailing direction, that is the forward direction, okay? So in this direction, if you want to take the left turn, so this is your left turn, which is observed from the top view. And this is your right turn. Okay, so when we want to take the left turn, that means there has to be some moment or the torque which is to be supplied on this ship in this direction that will rotate the complete ship about the z axis. Okay, because if you want to take the left or right turn, we have to rotate this ship about this z axis. Okay, either in this direction, that is from top direction, it will be anti-clockwise, so it will be the left turn, okay? And if you rotate this in this direction, that is if you observe from the top direction in the clockwise direction, then it is the right turn, okay? So just forget about the right turn. So if you observe from the top direction, and this is the torque vector or the torque direction, okay? So it is in the anti-clockwise direction, that means it is a left turn, okay? So for the left turn, we have to apply the torque in this direction. So because of this left turn, this propeller or propeller blade or its axis, it will rotate in this direction, okay? And the gyroscopic couple is produced when we rotate the axis of spin about the perpendicular axis. Okay, so same case is happening here. When we are rotating the complete ship about this z axis, we are actually rotating this axis of spin of this spinning object, that is a propeller. Okay, and because of this, this complete ship will experience some gyroscopic couple. So let us understand the direction of the gyroscopic couple and its effect on this naval ship. So first we have to draw the vector in the direction of the initial angular momentum of the propeller, okay? So this propeller, so it is initially rotating in the clockwise direction, which is observed from this direction, okay? And as per the thumb rule, as it is rotating in this direction, we have to curl the finger in the same direction, okay? So curl the finger in the same direction of the angular velocity. So this is your angular velocity omega. Then thumb will denote the direction of the angular momentum vector or the angular velocity vector. Okay. So as the propeller is rotating in the clockwise direction, this is the thumb rule. We have to curl the finger in the direction of that vector, direction of angular velocity. This thumb, it will denote the direction of vector, that is angular momentum. So your initial angular momentum is like this. Okay, so this is L, which is equal to I into omega. This is your initial angular momentum vector for the propeller. Now, when we are rotating the ship in the left direction, that means we are taking the left turn. So for that, we are adding some extra momentum because of the torque, because we are adding the torque value in this direction. So for the torque, there will be angular momentum. So again, we have to use the same thumb rule. So we have to curl the finger in the direction of this torque. So this thumb, it will denote the direction of the angular momentum vector. So along this direction, we are adding some momentum because of the torque. This torque is necessary in order to rotate this shape in the left side. Okay. So add this vector to the initial angular momentum. So actually this Li omega vector, it is in this plane. That is a plane of the water, which is XY plane. Okay. Now this small angular momentum is being added in which direction? In the perpendicular Z direction. So this is the added angular momentum. Now what is the effect? When we are actually taking the left turn, we are adding some momentum in the perpendicular direction to the initial angular momentum, which is L is equal to I omega. So this momentum vector, it will try to get aligned with the new angular momentum vector. So finally, this is a vector addition. So this is L. So this will be your L dash. That is the final angular momentum. So we will observe some angular change in the axis of spin, because this Li omega, it represents the axis of spin, that is the axis of this propeller. Okay. L dash will also represent the axis of spin only. But after some time, it will change the direction because of the small added angular momentum when we apply the torque while taking the left turn. So what is the effect? This, if you observe from this side, so I will just draw the side view. So this is the propeller. So when we are taking the left turn, actually that left turn is not visible in the front view. So I will draw the top view. Okay, so this is the top view. So when we are taking the left turn, so your ship, its orientation will be like this. So this is the position of the ship after the left turn. Okay, so this change is observed only in the top view. So at the same time, the axis of spin, it will get aligned with this L dash. Okay, so for that, we will observe the extra movement in the ship. So this is the extra movement. So now observe the effect of this triangle. Okay. So we have initial vector in this direction, which is the L, initial angular momentum. Okay. Because of this motion, some momentum gets added because of the torque. and the axis of spin, that is the axis of this propeller, try to align with the new angular momentum. And therefore, this turned end, that is the rear end, it moves in the upward direction. And the front end, which is the bow end, it moves in the downward direction. Okay, so this unnecessary moment gets added on the ship. Okay, and this is the effect of gyroscopic couple. Okay, the gyroscopic couple acts along this y axis and it tries to, so I will show the gyroscopic couple. So this is the gyroscopic couple. Okay, so because of this couple, the bow end, it moves in the downward direction and the stern end, it moves in the upward direction. So this is unintentional movement. Okay, actually we are not providing any torque to cause this motion. Okay, so actually there is a pitching motion because of the turning. So the effect is, when the propeller is rotating in the clockwise direction, so this is observed from the front end, that is a bow end, and if the ship is taking the left turn, then the bow end moves in the downward direction and the stern, that is the rear end, stern end, it moves in the upward direction. Okay, so this is the additional movement which is gets added on the ship because of the steering motion, which is steering towards the left side. Okay, so let us see if the ship is steering towards the right side. So if you want, you can take the screenshot and then draw this diagram again so that you can understand the gyroscopic couple axis. So this is your gyroscopic couple axis, y axis. So name can be different in the book. So this is gyroscopic couple axis. So this axis is perpendicular to the spinning axis. So let us discuss the case where the ship is taking the right turn. So the effect, that is gyroscopic couple, it depends on two points. First is the direction of the propeller, whether it is a clockwise or anti-clockwise. And second, whether the ship is taking left turn or the right. So here I will assume the propeller is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction which is observed from the front end. And if the ship taking the right turn, okay, so in order to see the turn, we have to observe in the top view. Okay, so what is the first condition? The propeller is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction observed from the front end. So if you observe from this side, that is the front end, you can see the propeller is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction like this. Okay, so as per the thumb rule, we have to curl the finger in the direction of the angular momentum. Okay, so thumb, it will denote, so this is your angular momentum, so this is angular velocity, so curl the finger in the direction of this angular velocity, so thumb, it will denote the angular momentum. So your angular momentum vector is like this. So this is initial angular momentum, which is L is equal to I omega. Now we want to take the right turn. So I will draw the axis. So this vector, it is along the axis of spin, and this is the perpendicular axis. So this is Z, this is Y, and this is X axis. Okay, so I haven't drawn the x-axis, just consider it is along the axis of spin or along this propeller shaft. So try to observe from the top direction so that you can visualize the right and left turn. So just imagine this is the observer. So from the top direction, you can observe the right turn. Okay, so right turn means, so this is the right turn. So right turn is from the sailor's end, that means you are in the ship and this is the direction of the sailing, okay, and therefore it is a right turn. So for the right turn, we have to apply the torque in this direction, okay, on the complete ship so that it will take the right turn. So because of this torque, some momentum, that is angular momentum, gets added in this momentum. So that angular momentum direction, we can decide again by using the thumb rule. So we have to curl the finger in the direction of this torque vector, okay? So this is the thumb rule. We have to curl the finger in this direction. Now this thumb, it will denote the extra momentum which is added in the original momentum. So this is our original momentum factor L. This is the extra momentum because of the torque. So let us assume this as a DL. So your final momentum factor. So this is the final momentum factor. So this is the L dash. Okay. And therefore, when the ship is taking the right turn, the axis of spin or the axis of the propeller will get aligned along this direction. That is along the new angular momentum vector. And because of this, the front end, that is the bow end, it moves down, and the stern end, it moves in the upward direction. Okay. So let us understand this with the front end top view. So we are taking the right turn. So after some time, so this is the orientation of the ship. Okay, so this is the right turn. At the same time, the another motion we can observe. So that is from this side view. So the complete ship, it will tilt in this direction. Okay, so this is because, so this is the reason for that. Okay, this axis of spin will get aligned along this L dash, that is a new angular momentum. So this is your initial angular momentum vector, that is L. Okay, because of this steering motion towards the right side, we are adding the torque. As we are adding the torque, we are adding the momentum. Okay, so this momentum is nothing but DL. So this is the added angular momentum. And because of this momentum, which is a DL, the resultant momentum, it will be along this vector. So that is the L dash. Okay. And therefore, this axis of spin of the propeller will try to align along this vector. And therefore, this is the final position. So this end, that is a front end or the bow end, it moves down, and the rear end, it moves up. So which is a stern. Okay. So with the help of this angular momentum vector, we can find out the final position of the bow end and the stern end, whether the ship is taking left turn or the right turn. Okay. So the third condition, so just I will write down the condition. You try to find out the direction, the direction of motion, okay, by using that angular momentum vector. So third is, if